Ladies and gentlemen, the first match of the evening. To my right, gentlemen, this match for the television championship. Rotunda defending against the Stinger and the entire entourage of the Varsity Club, including financial officer Chip Burnham with a big bag full of money. It's $10,000 in there.
Jim Ross, has been an exciting show today, and you know yourself as well as I do that no matter which way you want to look at it, you owe Mike Rotunda an apology. He's facing the top challenger that you suggested.
I suggested last week that he was dodging the top competition, and the NWA heard that suggestion, and they forced this contract signing. Rotunda not too happy about the signing, but he did accept the terms for this championship bout. Collar and elbow tie up. Rotunda with a side headlock. The Stinger shoots him off. Nice football tackle by Rotunda. What a leapfrog by the Stinger. High hip lock takeover. And the challenger, ooh, what a clothesline, is on fire. Lateral press, 1, 2. Referee Nick Patrick assigned this event.
I know Mike Rotunda, undoubtedly the greatest world television champion of all time. And now here's a smart move, Jim. Sting started off with a bang, and they went to the floor, stopped the momentum.
They made a little huddle there. Talked over strategy. I'll tell you something, the odds are certainly against the challenger. All the entourage is here. The coach, Kevin Sullivan.
They have just as much right to cheer on their comrade as anybody else.
I would feel much more comfortable though, Michael, if they were seated with the fans, if they want to watch this match and not observe so closely, if you understand my meaning.
Well, I hate to burst your bubble, but the NWA doesn't live just to make you comfortable, all right?
It wasn't very comfortable for the Stinger, who stepped right out of the corner after that tremendous shot by Mike Rotunda. Remember, tomorrow it's 3:30 Eastern Time, live here on the Superstation. 10 great matches, Michael Hayes, 3 championships on the line as the Stinger's got a side headlock on Mike Rotunda. Rotunda with a waistlock, trying to jockey for position here. He takes the Stinger back to the ropes and shoots him off. Oh, and he nailed him with a knee right to the midsection. The Stinger goes down.
Well-placed knee, and Jim, that's what Mike Rotunda's got to do. It's got to be his game plan to keep Sting down, keep him on the mat, keep him from standing up and doing that explosive flying. Keep his legs pinned down.
The Stinger's got that great leaping ability. Oh, what a move. The Stinger dropped down.
Now, wait a minute.
Rotunda didn't
over
even
the top rope.
He didn't even
that's
touch
a disqualification.
The Stinger never touched Rotunda.
That was a disqualification.
Momentum took him over. That was momentum. Sting did not throw him over the top rope.
That's a judgment call there.
It certainly is, but referee Nick Patrick, I think, judged correctly. It was Rotunda's momentum, not the Stinger, that put him over the top rope as the Varsity Club once again huddles out here outside the ring. This is a battle for the World Television Championship.
And not only for that, 10,000 big ones right here, Jimbo.
And we're holding it right here in front of us. 10,000 bucks neatly tucked away in this bag.
You know, if I'm not mistaken, looking into Sting's past and his career, he's never held a single major title before, has he?
Not yet.
And I don't think after today he will either.
Well, it certainly remains to be seen. Rotunda with a tremendous European-style forearm that sends the Stinger down. We talked about the challenger's leaping ability, his agility. And he's also got great power. What an elbow coming off the ropes. He caught Rotunda again with a scoop slam. And high elevation. Oh, but he missed it. That leaping ability did not turn into an asset on that occasion.
Well, as I say, Jim went to the well and it was dry. But you know, still, Sting, one thing that does impress you, whether you like him or not about him, is his stamina. His stamina. He can go and go and keep going. That's why right now, this is not a cowardly move on Rotundo's part. Besides, he got poked in the eyes, which is illegal. He's slowing down the momentum.
The Stinger really, I think, wrestles better when the crowd is into it, and they are into it here in Atlanta.
Oh, he looks real good in those cute pink tights.
Well, they're certainly colorful, no doubt about it. Rotunda steps back into the ring. The man from Syracuse, New York. Collar and elbow tie up. It's the Stinger with the advantage here. Taking Rotunda over in a side headlock position. And Rotunda turns him over. Rotunda's feet are in the ropes. And Stinger rolled on his shoulder for a moment as Rotunda used the ropes for leverage.
You know, one thing, even though Sting has the upper advantage right now, Jim Ross, in another sense, Mike Rotunda has the mental advantage because he's slowed down the match to this point and he's able to start thinking. He's a thinking man's wrestler. He's two, maybe three, sometimes even as much as four moves ahead of his opponent.
Michael, you've wrestled with groups before and involved in groups before, obviously the Fabulous Freebirds. What's it like as far as an athlete's concerned? What's going through the Stinger's mind now with three adversaries in essence watching this closely at ringside? Will that be a distraction?
Well, yes, it should be, and that's basically the whole meaning for them to be out there anyway. Because if he's not solely concentrated on what he needs to be at his opponent, which is Mike Rotunda, and the conquest which he wants to be successful at is taking his 10 grand and the world television title. They haven't touched anybody. They haven't interfered in the match, have they?
No, they haven't.
Okay. And as a matter of fact,
I hope they keep it that way as the Stinger turns on the pressure.
Rotunda's got to stop him. He's such an excitable wrestler. He gets motivated and he doesn't stop.
Stinger certainly has the momentum right now until that move. Great suplex.
That's what I'm talking about, thinking. While he was in that headlock, he was thinking not only how to get out of it, once he did, what'd he do? Whoa! Sting tried to move, but he didn't miss. Didn't get out of it totally, Jim. Not all the way.
Certainly didn't. Oh, Rotunda missed with a drop kick. Boy, they are competing hard here. And now the Stinger with a right hand. Now goes Rotunda. Indeed, it was a closed fist. And Rotunda is going down memory lane here, perhaps down to the Hallett Hall. Probably not the study hall. I don't know how much time he spent there at Syracuse. Perhaps a great deal. I don't know.
He spent a lot of time there. He's all about
oh, yeah, and a cop! What a move over the top rope! And a right hand! It's breaking down! And the Stinger, in the face of adversity, is cooking! He's on the top rope, Michael!
We're trying to look out! Rotunda is still in this match and still the champion at this point. He's got to stop Sting's momentum.
Rotunda has got to control the tempo. He's got to take this athlete off his feet and slow down the momentum as we have been stating. But right now, the challenger.
What's he doing out here?
And there is the final package. And it's the Dragon Steamboat. They're showing their camaraderie, their support for their friend, for their ally, the Stinger. And if the Varsity Club can be at ringside, Michael Hayes, then so can Lex Luger and Ricky Steamboat.
They have no right being here.
They have as much right as the Varsity Club does at ringside.
They are not associated as closely with Sting as this group is.
Something you might know a lot about. You were once their friend, too, if you could remember that.
I was never a friend of Luger's. This world ain't big enough for his ego and mine, so I did something with him. Come on, Rotunda. Now, I'm supposed to be unbiased out here.
Sting still controls the tempo. He is still controlling this match. A side headlock with the Stinger. Tightly applied.